Hi, this is Lisa Allen, and in this video, we'll finish up this series on video marketing by uploading and search optimizing a video. So there are a number of different things you can do to give your video a little push so that it will start to rank in YouTube and also in Google. And you can see here I have the basics listed. We're going to talk about the file name. We're going to talk about optimizing video titles, the video descriptions and what should be in the video description. Also going to talk about how to choose tags and video captions, and then also playlists and why you should embed the video. So let's get started. So first, you will need to make sure that you rename the file to use the main keyword that you are trying to optimize for before you upload it. So if I was trying to optimize for the words video marketing, I might change this to video marketing 6 tips. And you can see now that I've got my keyword in the actual video file. And Google actually does look at the name of the file when you upload it, even though it doesn't really show it on your channel. So that's the first place that you need to optimize it. Now, once you've uploaded your video, you'll also want to optimize the video's title. If at all possible, put the keyword at the front of the video title. The title should also be catchy or promise a benefit. And you can also go and do your keyword search on YouTube and look at the titles of the first several videos, and sometimes you can see a common theme or a common way that they formatted their title, and it will give you some ideas for how you might make a title that would be successful in being ranked. And you can see here that I put the words video marketing in this, but because I was making a whole series, I didn't put it at the front because I also wanted people to be able to tell the difference between the videos and move from video to video. So you just have to decide which way you want it. Do you need the keyword at the front, or is there other information that's more important for your particular videos? Now, another thing that's really, really important when optimizing your video is to optimize the description. There are several things that you need to do when you're optimizing the description. One of them is to put the link here at the very top. And the reason you do that is that when this displays on YouTube, only the first couple of lines will be there unless somebody actually opens the rest of the description. And so you want the link to be right there where you have a possibility of getting some traffic from it. Next, you'll also want to include some closely related keywords to build relevance for your video. So for video marketing, I also included the word video editing, and then I also have marketing videos, and then a short description. As far as the related keywords go, you'll want to have these be keywords that Google thinks are closely related. So to find out which keywords Google thinks are closely related to your keyword, you'll want to go to the Google's keyword tool and type in your keyword, select only show ideas closely related to my search terms, and then search for some related keywords. Now these are ordered by relevance, and so the ones that are at the top are more related. So you'll want to pick 4 or 5 additional keywords to put in your video description that actually are from about the first 20. And the closer to the top they are, the better relevance that they have. So maybe I would pick viral video marketing, web video marketing, online video marketing, and maybe, let's see, video marketing tools perhaps, or video marketing tips. Maybe get rid of one of these that's a synonym. Maybe take those 4, and then you just click on View as Text, and you can copy these keywords out of here. And then you go back to your description and find a way to work those keywords in, either in the description, or you can just put those as a list of comma-separated terms. Now, you remember that back in video 2, you learned how to write a script, and I told you to save that script. Well, I hope you still have it. One thing that is really helpful when writing the description is to just put your script in the description underneath your links and the additional keywords. And this will save you a ton of time because you don't have to write a huge description. Now, if your script is too long, you can chop it off at the bottom or write a short article instead, as I've done here. But the script is what I often use. And then next, what you'll want to do is find some good relevant tags. So you can see here I've used things that are related directly to the video, like it's a tutorial, it's on video editing, video marketing, Camtasia, make videos, marketing. And one thing that you also want to do with a lot of these little tags is that you can see I've got some phrases here like how to edit videos. You can also do how to edit videos. And it's been shown that YouTube actually does consider the combinations of these tags. So if you put individual phrases as individual words, if somebody types in something that's not exactly this term, it still may show up because the individual words that make up that phrase are in the tags. And of course, you should use some of your related words in the tags. So if I have my related words here, actually, I would need to take the comma separated list here and paste that in my tags. And you can see now that I've got a bunch of related terms in my tags as well. And the last trick that I have for you regarding tags is that you can check your competitors of the videos that are already ranking and take their tags. So in order to do that, let's just type in video marketing and search YouTube. And you'll want to make sure that you notice that these are the ads and don't do your targeting based on these because these guys paid to get here, so they aren't really your competition. So you notice this one was just barely posted and has no views, so this one may be appearing at the top just because it's a brand new video, but it probably won't stay there. So what you really want to do is go to one that's been on longer and is ranked near the top. So let's look at this one and then just right click and view the page source. And if you go here to meta name equals keywords right here, you can see content equals video marketing, sold with video, small business marketing, video, video ads, video marketing advice, video marketing tips, business, small business. And it does cut off some of the later tags, but you can still take the most important tags out of here. So go through several of the videos and take the actual tags and make sure you add them to your tags if you're targeting the same keyword, because these are tags that are working for people. Now, once you have your tags created, you also want to go to the video captions section. And you can see here there's a blue button that says upload caption file or transcript. So the other thing that we're going to do with the script that I had you write in video two is to upload your caption file. And then you'll just want to upload the script that you made for the video before you recorded it. And so here's my script. Click on open. That's a transcript. And click on upload. And it's processing it as it tries to match up with what's in the actual audio. And it will take it a few minutes. But YouTube does actually look inside the transcript and the caption files also for relevant information on your video. So this is another way to optimize your video so that the search terms that you're looking for are considered more important by Google. So there are just a couple of more things that I'm going to show you on optimizing this. One of those is to add the video to a playlist. And in order to add the video to the playlist, you go to the watch page for the video, you click on add to, and you can see down here we've got a list of playlists, or you can create a new playlist for this to go on. And you can see that I have a video marketing tips playlist. And by using your keyword in the playlist, it also builds relevance for your video to the keyword. And then another thing that you do when you add the video to the playlist is that you add a note. And the note should be a catchy little enticement for people to watch the video, and it can contain your keyword. So by adding a playlist that has your keyword and putting your keywords or related keywords in the notes, you again build relevance for your video. And as far as the playlists go, once you have a playlist, you also should go and find some other related but non-competing videos on YouTube and add them to the playlist, which will also build relevance for you without you having to make another video. Okay, so there is one last thing that you need to do to give your video a boost, and that is to go to the video watch page, click on share, click on embed, and copy this code here from this little box, and this is the embed code, and you can change it to different video sizes. But what you need to do is you need to go to either your blog or your website or even your web 2.0 blogs that you might have for marketing purposes, and you need to just take this video and embed it one or two places. And basically what this does is that it helps Google know that this video is important, that people actually want to watch it. Even if you only embed it on your own website, it will still give you a boost. And the reason why it's helpful is that the factors that YouTube uses for ranking videos in rough order of importance are number one, optimized titles, descriptions, and tags, And then the in-video optimizations, such as the captions and the annotations. And also, third is the number of embeds that the video has. And fourth is number of positive ratings. Fifth, number of views and comments. And then the lastly, number of video responses. So you can see that the number of embeds is actually third on the list of ranking factors. So by embedding your video a number of places, or even just one place, it will help Google know that this video is important and it should pay attention to it. So that's it for this video on video optimization steps. And if you like this video, please leave a comment or subscribe or share it. So thanks for watching, and I hope you have enjoyed this series.